Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dusty Sheet channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And I have a box. A medium-sized box. And you've seen the title of this video. This box contains an airplane. Yes, and an airplane from iFlight. This is, for as far as I know, at least their first airplane. And iFlight FEV quadcopters, drones, right? Motors, they are very well known for their Xing motors. And so yeah, this is their first try at an FPV airplane, an FPV wing. And it is quite different than the wings you might be used to. Most of the wings we see nowadays are foam made. This one is definitely not. It is also not a budget airplane. But, well, as you'll see, it doesn't look like a budget airplane either. So, what we'll do in this video, I'll show you the FPV wing in detail. I will tell you what I think of it, of the construction and what you get with the wing. And I'll show you what extra gear I'll use to get this thing in the air. And well, after that I'm gonna build it and hopefully I'll be able to fly it in the next couple of days, obviously. Alright, let's go. Oh, disclaimer, this is a production prototype, a pre-production version. And I do think that it's pretty close, if not identical to the production version. And this packaging might be the major thing that'll change. And mine is wrapped in bubble wrap, as you can see. But I suspect that they'll make a custom package for this airplane. And with that, second disclaimer, I was sent this airplane for review for free by iFlight. Just so you know. Okay, let's see what you get when you order this plane. Okay, so again, the parts of my airplane were all wrapped in bubble wrap. I've actually already taken them out, as you can see. But every part of the airplane was securely wrapped in bubble wrap. However, again, I suspect that they will make a foam, molded foam packaging for all the parts. Okay, so we've got a center fuselage over here. And we obviously have two wings. Servo already installed, as you can see. There, two wings. And you can already see that this is completely different from the foam wings you you and I actually have been used to for the last couple of years. This looks old school. It looks covered, like it looks like a balsa model which is then covered. However, it is not. This is glass fiber and then spray painted. Yeah. And there is some balsa construction in this wing, but actually what you see is all fiberglass. Same goes for the center fuselage. There is some balsa wood inside. Balsa wood's a support structure. Mostly for your LiPo and maybe a flight controller and such. Yeah, and there is some carbon fiber reinforcement here and there. So again, even though it looks old school, it is not. Old school, again, would have been balsa and then covering film. This is all fiberglass. And yeah, there are links in the description to this airplane. I've got a link to iFlight's own webshop in the description down below and to Banggood. As you'll see, this airplane is not cheap. And I can imagine that making a plane This way isn't cheap either. So, yeah. And it looks stunning. In my humble opinion, of course. Okay, and we've got some wingtips. And what is this? This is corrugated plastic, I think this is called. Plastic cardboard. And you might have come across photos or videos in which this airplane has fiberglass wingtips. iFlight tells me that those fiberglass wingtips will be optional. So if you order this airplane, and I've got the version with electronics, as you can see, it has a motor, and we'll see an ESC in a couple of minutes, and it has servos pre-installed. However, those fiberglass wingtips are optional. Standard wingtips are these corrugated plastic ones. Okay, we've got some installation hardware. More on that in a second. We'll take a closer look. And we've got an ESC over here. Straps, four straps, luxurious. Some Velcro, an XT60 connector with wire already pre-soldered. So, okay, and decals, thank you very much. Okay, and last thing in the box is two propellers. And this is actually funny. This is a standard direction propeller and a counter-rotating propeller. So if you end up having to use the spare propeller, you'll have to reverse the motor direction as well. It's super easy, by the way, because the motor has bullet connectors on it, as you can tell. So that's super duper easy. Okay, the assembly of this aeroplane. And consequently also the disassembly for maybe transport or storage. As you can tell, each wing has this bar over here, which it has a threading in it, metal bar with threading, and you get two of these thumb screws, which will secure the wings to the center fuselage, right? And you get a another, what is this, carbon? Yeah, it's, or I'm not sure. Carbon spar, probably a carbon spar, which will slot into this hole at the rear of each of the wings, like so. Okay, and obviously you need to thread the servo wire into the fuselage, but as you can tell, super easy to take the airplane apart again. If again you want to transport it in a backpack, for instance, more than possible. Or, well, if you have a small car, or, well, if you want to store it, very easy to take it apart again. So, the rear spar over here, we feed the servo wire into the fuselage. And this is probably gonna be a tight fit. Oh, it's okay. It's a tight fit, but not ridiculously. We take the thumb screw. And we secure the wing in place. Now, some recent planes have actually used magnets, right? To secure the wings to the center fuselage, and could have been possible, but this will work. I noticed that there is a little bit of play. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that over here. So what I will probably end up doing is adding some tape to the bottom over here to really strap the wing to the fuselage and keep it in place. There is no lateral play, so in the up and down direction. But again, there is a little bit of play in this direction. Yep, definitely. All right. The other wing. same deal. Okay, what I actually find is that I have no play on this side. I've got some play over here, and on this side I don't have any play. So I will have a look at what is actually causing this. I can again easily solve it with a little bit of tape. But this might be something that iFlight will have to check. If this is a structural problem or not. Okay, so, but it looks really gorgeous, right? And the elevons are pre-installed, as you can tell, pre-hinged as well. In some of these kinds of models, you have to glue in hinges, not in this case, which is great. What does that look like at the bottom? Gorgeous, actually. Yeah, so at the rear, we already have that motor, right? One of the infamous Zing motors, and this is a 2150 kV from the looks of it. Is that correct? Actually, I'll put that in the specifications. However, this should be a 4S motor, 4S setup, together with the 7-inch propeller. And this is basically a big 2208 quadcopter motor, right? And what you can also see, and that's a good thing, of course, we've got a carbon fiber motor mount over here, but also cooling vents. So from the rear of the plane, the propeller will pull a lot of air through the fuselage for cooling of your LiPo and your ESC and probably a video transmitter, so that's great. Plenty of cooling vents at the rear over here. And this, all of the motor mount looks to be carbon fiber. And yeah, it looks very well made. Everything looks very well made so far, which is great. At the front, we see this large gaping hole, which is, partially meant for taking in cooling air, of course, but mostly for an action camera and your FPV camera side by side. It is a bit big, and there is no filling, foam filling or anything supplied with the airplane. Surely you have some leftover packaging foam, and as do I, so I'll make something in to fill this up. Do be mindful, of course, that you do leave some holes for air cooling. And let me see, yeah, in my case, the servos are pre-installed. These are digital and Metal Gear servos. So neither did they skimp out on the motor, but these servos are pretty beefy as well. No 9-gram wimpy servos in this airplane, so that's great. Now, the control horns and links are more luxurious than what you'd see in most of the airplanes we see in this hobby. At least, it's more luxurious than most of the airplanes I buy. This hardware, and I'll give you a close-up look of the control horn, so that the thing that's screwed down on the elevon. This is what you'd see on larger scale models generally. So basically very luxurious, which is great to see, of course. Now, the wingtips. You'll have to install the wingtips, of course. And as you can tell, this corrugated plastic does have two holes in it. And you get some self-tapping screws for, obviously, to install them. However, the wingtips themselves do not have holes pre-drilled. And what I will do is I'll hot glue them onto the wingtips and then drill into the wingtips. That way these corrugated wingtips are fixed in place, right? And yeah, I won't be missing the spot, so to speak. And iFlight tells me that they only hot glue them in place. Even though I have seen photos from iFlight in which they had used the screw. So again, I think it's a good thing to use both some glue and the screws to fasten the wingtips. Okay, a quick look at the rest of the stuff you get with this airplane. You get two carbon fiber servo hole covers. Great. And you get a lot of zip ties, and I'm not sure why, but you can never have enough zip ties. Okay, you get four battery strips, as mentioned before. They have two lengths, so maybe for different sizes of battery packs, or maybe you could use the shorter ones for your action camera. And you get an XT60 with wires, leads pre-soldered to it. Great. You get a 60 amp, no less than 60 amp, Sussex from iFlight themselves, ESC. And it has booted connectors pre-soldered to it. Very convenient. However, you obviously do need to solder up that XT60 with wires to that ESC. And also, this ESC has, because it's basically a quadcopter ESC, right? It doesn't have a BEC, battery limiter circuit. So this ESC can't supply voltage for instance, your receiver or the servos. Which is why they supply this with the airplane. A step-down regulator or Pelulu. So this steps down your battery voltage to 5.5 volts for your receiver and for your servos. Now, I have told eFlight that I think it would be better to ship the airplane with a power distribution board, which you'd find in quadcopters. More versatile and easier to work with. That's my opinion. Speaking of, here is some of the stuff I will be using to finish this airplane up. I'll be using a Speedybee flight controller. An F4 flight controller, there you go. And as you can tell, this flight controller has an integrated power distribution board. So yeah, with this, I will have several advantages. I can set up the flight controller via Bluetooth with my phone. That's one of the things with this Speedybee flight controller. I've done a review of this flight controller, and I'll have a link up there about this flight controller. And okay, so I'll have a power distribution board which will deliver 5 or probably also 10 volts for my receiver and the servos. And I'll have an OSD with this. Excellent, right? So that should work out well. And again, I will be flying the plane without this flight controller's assistance, at least at the start. Now, as this is an FPV airplane, at least to me, I'll be using this VTX video transmitter. This is a, what is this? An AKK Tag FX2, not the latest, but I had this one in the parts bin. And this is an 800 milliwatt capable VTX, more than enough, right? It does smart audio, so presto, very, very nice. And I'll be using a Runcam Swift 2 full-size FPV camera. That one I haven't in yet. It's on order, should be in momentarily. I hope to be able to install it this week. And okay, here is the FPV antenna I'll be using, circular wireless. And I've selected this one because it should have a low air resistance because it doesn't have a covering. This is a very good antenna, by the way. It's also a bit fragile, as you can imagine. But well, this is not a quadcopter, so yeah, I'm chancing it. And the last thing we'll need is some lipos. And I at this moment, I'm not sure what I'll use. I've got some 2200 4S lipos. I've got a 2600 and I got a 2800. And I'll just see how the plane balances out. And I'll tell you in my maiden flight video what I end up using of these lipos. All right, closing thoughts on this iFlight iWing. I will obviously have to look into this play. And this is a pre-production model, right? This is nothing out of the ordinary for a pre-production model. I will look into it, however, and well, maybe I'll do a short update video on this if I find out what causes this. And apart from that, if you were looking for an indestructible wing, an EPP wing, in other words, then this simply isn't it. And I have no idea if you'd be landing on a rocky surface, how this fiberglass and especially the finishing on it would hold up. I really don't know. Maybe after a while it'll have some more character because of some scraping and such. You could add a little bit of tape maybe on strategic places. The plane will be partially guarded by those corrugated plastic wingtips, of course, but this center, yeah, might be nice to add some tape. I also noticed that it has a CG marker over here, which is obviously a great idea. Thank you very much. That'll make things a lot easier. And apart from it being wear resistant or not, an airplane like this will fly, it'll probably fly fast, but also very precise because it's very stiff. I have one of my self-built foam board airplanes has a lot of carbon fiber in it, making it very stiff, and an airplane like that flies differently. Again, more precisely. And yeah. We'll find out if that's actually the case in our flight tests. I'm gonna be building it, and well, there's again not a whole lot of building. I'll have to slap on the wingtips and install a receiver and such. Yeah, shouldn't be all too hard, and I'll have to figure out something to close up this gaping hole. It looks a little bit like a whale shark. This. Speaking of, some of you might say this doesn't look all that aerodynamic. It looks very wide. Well, yeah. If I wouldn't have made it wide, you do need to somehow store a lipo in the fuselage, right? And an action camera. However, still, yeah, it's a little wide, this nose. We'll see. I've seen plenty of flight videos from iFlight themselves, and it's very fast. So, but still, I would have liked to have seen this nose be a little more aerodynamic. Oh well. Still, I shouldn't complain, because it's a very special looking airplane, in my humble opinion, and I'm not saying that because I got it for free. And well, if iFlight never wants to send me anything ever again, I'm fine with that. But yeah. Okay, again, if you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below, or suggestions or whatever. And in the coming weeks, I'll hope to be able to fly this airplane, and if it doesn't fly well, I'll show you as well. K catch you on the next video. Bye bye.